Hey guys, welcome back to Life is Strange Before the Storm. We're going to be doing the bonus episode today. Well, let's continue.
Ready? I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak?
She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing.
I bet she'll notice a hole in the floor.
Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
Me, that wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen.
That was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome?
That's like asking, why are puppies cute? Some things just are.
I'm not sure your mom would see it that way.
When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
Alright. It looks like we're gonna be helping her clean her room.
It feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over. In a few days, my whole family moves to Seattle. I have no idea when I'll see Chloe again. This could be my last chance to say goodbye. But how do you tell your best friend that you're leaving her?
Life is strange before the storm. Farewell.
I better help Chloe with her cleaning. And while I'm at it, I can take... Chloe and I haven't played this game in forever. And I'm pretty sure it's missing pieces. Let this box of trash be a sacrifice to you, oh almighty Chloe Bit.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way. Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
Chloe, we haven't played this game in years, and it's missing half the pieces.
Nice try, Max. But you can't erase your shame that easily.
Okay, so we can't throw that away.
Chloe's had this hung up on her wall forever, but neither of us can figure out what happened to the last panel. I hope Dr. Kloenstein's okay. Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour. Chloe keeps trying to get me to hop on her board. Whoa. Talk about embarrassing. about these boy band trading cards? Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all makeovers?
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
And yet, our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
I mean, she wants us to help her clean her room, but every single time we find trash, she just says nope.
That was awesome. Who else but Chloe could turn cleaning her room into a pyrotechnical adventure? This seems like a good candidate.
Are you insane? That's my entire magic collection. Do you know how many weeks of allowance this cost?
You haven't touched these since the fifth grade talent show.
Maybe because my assistant turned out to be squeamish at the sight of fake blood.
At least you didn't saw me in half. How are you planning to clean this place if you won't throw away anything?
A magician never reveals her secrets. Put it back.
Okay, whenever I'm ready, I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her.
Yeah, I think we're done with trash for sure.
Hey, did you see my dad's camera yet? Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Sure, just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes. You're off to a great start.
Actually, it's kind of cool. That's it. I'm calling off the search. If you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two undersupervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later. The possibilities are endless. Got anything in mind?
Actually, you bet your ass I do. I found this when I was digging around before you got here. You're gonna flip! Do you have any idea what this is?
Whatever it is, it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Your powers of deduction are as strong as ever. This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Ready to find out?
Avast, future wayfarer! Ye have uncovered the audio log of the most fearsome pirates in the bays of Arcadia!
Oh, you are such dorks.
So, you're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
mine eyes spot two fair pirate wenches.
What a... Dad, get away! We're in the middle of an important project.
Oh, project. Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it.
All right. Supper's in five. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame. As I was saying, if it's treasure you seek, forewarned. The journey will be treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard. Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again, only those with pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
Good luck. And, bye.
Dude, that was hilarious. We were so, so ridiculous. We still are, Max. We still are. Okay, okay. Forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting. I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
Okay.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map. Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
All right. Time to find this map. Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class. I wonder if the map is mixed in with her school supplies. People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool.
Yeah, it's not in there.
Don't move. This angle is perfect.
Why be shy? Get in here, dude. Subject and photographer. You really do it all, Max.
I try. Bingo.
Chloe's secret lair, dark cavern.
I'm remembering this now. Didn't we make some crazy puzzle? You need the telescope and the amulet.
Which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic.
Ugh, why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
You think it's still there?
Should be. As long as the clean police haven't gotten to it first.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
You mean the swings?
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver right again, bitches!
Chloe seems so into this. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure. Okay, Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way in is through the broom closet. There it is. The dark cavern. Crap. I can't get into the attic if I can't even reach the door. I need to find something to stand on. I'm sure I can find something around here to boost me up.
Yep, the crate.
It's a start. I gotta find something I can stack on top of it. Seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house.
I mean, you're not supposed to walk into other people's bedrooms without the permission, but...
just need a few more inches.
Listen to these books.
I think that should be tall enough. There's a ton of stuff up here. How will I ever... There it is. Of course Chloe hid the amulet in the hardest place to get to. I need to find a way through.
And you could push the chair.
I think I can squeeze through now.
No, we're going that way.
It's a good thing I'm big and burly. Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kind of difficult. Keep it moving, desk. Crap. You have to go back.
I know. Live again.
I've got to get through, which means this desk has got to move. need to move that cooler, but this desk is in the way. One step closer.
Okay, now we could push the desk and then pull the cooler.
This thing is empty. Finally. This is a nice close-up shot. A fitting reward for a journey full of treasures. Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works.
Got it! Nothing can stop the mighty blue beard.
Chloe Price. My best friend. It's so weird being back in this attic after so long. I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about. And spiders. I'm gonna miss her.
Are you just watching me up there, Creeper?
I'm just getting some light. This cavern is even darker than I remembered.
Did you conquer your fears?
You could say that.
Get your ass down here. We have treasure to find.
On my way. No big deal.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes me walk the plank. Hey, Chloe.
Yar.
Land ho. Perfect.
Wait just a minute. Yarr! You must ask permission before setting foot, or peg, on another captain's boat!
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Grrr!
One amulet. Coming right up. Okay, I think it goes... Damn it. I forget how to make this... stay on. Stay here. I'll find something to hold it on. Thanks, Max.
Yeah.
Time to stick the amulet to the telescope. Chloe's bottle rocket. The fastest way to get an entire bottle of soda in your hair.
Ah, my greatest work of art. I call it... How I lost my magnifying glass privileges.
Great art is never appreciated. This thing looks so much smaller than I remember. I can't believe Chloe still has it. Actually, after this morning, I can. Poor Bongo. Chloe took his death so hard.
As in Bongo was a cat.
Score. One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is.
Avast, matey. Have you brought me prize?
Ahoy, Bluebeard. I have brought the stickiest tape in all the seven seas.
Well done, fellow scallywag.
Just like old times. Come, Max.
Remember how we used to talk about ruling the bays of Arcadia one day? We thought we were gonna be pirates forever. If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, then we'll always be pirates.
Hell yeah.
Would you like to do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Me? Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure. Wait. How am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with... something?
Here goes nothing. Okay. This drawing is supposed to line up with something.
Wait.
I think the drawing should turn the real world into something piratey. I think I have the right angle, but where does it line up?
I mean, it's supposed to be.
I'm so close. I just need to keep looking. Got it.
Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
Okay, take a step right. No, no, the other right.
My other right or your other right?
My other right.
Got it. Wait, what?
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me. Bingo.
Wonder what it is.
What is this?
I don't know. Let's open it.
From Bloody Bill. Who's that?
I'll get the tape player.
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
That's their dad.
Ahoy there, plankwalkers! It's me, Bloody Bill, the Pirate King.
What the heck?
By now you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary. I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given it extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you. Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed, and always remember, the real treasure is...
friendship.
Love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
Yeah.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground. Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive! Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. To Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you were so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine.
Hey, Chloe, how are you today? Oh, favorite animal, herbivore horse. Favorite food, lobster roll, mac, coffee. Favorite class in school, art or library? Science.
How about mine? What did I write?
This is so Chloe.
You were really funny. Mine was so serious.
Well, yeah, that's you. Serious and genuine. This is so cool. There's so much to look at.
Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Dunno. I thought they'd be home by now. Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff. I'm gonna draw something.
All these memories. I want to look at everything. This container looks like it could last 100 years.
Holy crap! It's the end of that comic in Chloe's room. Oh, this is gross.
These are awesome. Most of these are pretty far off base. It's so hard to predict the future. Maybe it's better to enjoy the present. It actually might be really fun to write letters to Chloe after I move. Recording things was so much fun in third grade. It's good to see you, old friend.
Ah, I keep messing up my picture.
There are no mistakes in art. That's so cool that Chloe's mom is thinking about this. You sure were troublesome to find. Manga might be the one thing where Chloe out-nerds. We always make so much more of a mess here than at my house. Chloe and I have been friends for so long.
And they have.
I still have. You're such a space hog. Move over.
Nope.
We need to tell her that we're gonna be moving. Don't want her to get mad.
Chloe and I spilled that wine months ago, but I still feel bad about it. Hey, what if my being in Seattle finally convinces Chloe to try an MMO?
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah. I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
Oh gosh, I really miss Bongo.
I saw you giving him a flower. It was so sweet.
Oh, Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa. Mushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once her parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She didn't like me getting mushy just now.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right?
I mean, if her parents come back, it might kick us out, so might as well tell her right now.
Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
My family's moving to Seattle really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
I should have just told you earlier. God, I feel so stupid.
Max, I said it was okay.
I thought about telling you this morning, but then I just felt guilty instead.
Well, I'm glad you didn't. Then it would have been hanging over us all day. That's why I didn't bring it up either. Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so I just left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
We'll keep in touch, okay? And visit, and maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do. Mom?
Black flies on the windowsill. That we are, that we are, that we are to know. Winter stole summer's thrill, and the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land, a dark and plumed estate. Hope your needs are humble.
She found out her dad died in a car accident. Really at the worst timing too, like we told her that we were leaving, and then even though she already knew, but it's weird, I've never really seen Max's parents.
Still I be a traveler. A gypsy's reins to face, but the road is weary with that fool found in your place.
this I know. But can't you see, or maybe you were the ocean when I was just a stone? So here we are.
Maybe this was a dumb idea. I would give anything to be there with you now. It's so hard trying to say what I'm thinking. If I could just see you. But we'll get good at it, great at it. We'll write and talk all the time, and then you'll come visit and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you. Goodbye.
Yeah, that's what happens, I guess. Then later on, she meets Rachel, and then Max comes back for Life is Strange. There's nothing at the end. No. Well, that was the bonus episode for Life is Strange. Hopefully, you enjoyed this series. It was a really good series. I'm looking forward to playing Life is Strange 2 later on. But yeah, thanks for watching.